So I've asked a friend, Elizabeth Mandel, who is a therapist. Now, Elizabeth is a couples therapist. She's been on Howard Stern. She's got quite an interesting take on things. And Liz, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.
Thank you. How are you?
I am doing great, Liz. So I'm talking about fantasy football, and I don't get it. And I was hoping that you could shed some light on this obsession that people seem to have, mostly men, I think.
Well, sure. I mean, fantasy is what Freud called a wish fulfillment. And essentially, it's a compensatory need to reconcile the banality of everyday life with our urge to break the rules. So a fantasy is living out the anxiety that we have to keep inside, and the fantasy football is similar to, you know, the scandal with Ashley Madison, where people were online, you know, philandering, and it's a means to escape.
All right, wait, Liz, let me back up there now. So the men who are obsessed with fantasy football, are you equating that to potentially being unfaithful to their spouse?
Sure, it derives from the same source, which is, you know, a need to live out vicariously through others based on a restless anxiety.
So what's the state of relationships in America and in New Jersey if you've got tens of millions of people completely addicted to it?
Well, fantasy football is a safe way to satisfy that, you know, need to kind of live through a fantasy and break the rules and have, you know, some measure of control in their lives that they may not feel on a regular basis. And it's definitely safer than cheating.
It's such an amazing take on it. All right. So what's your advice now for the women out there whose husbands and boyfriends, significant others, are completely obsessed with this? What do you advise them to do? Should they say, hey, I feel like you're cheating on me?
Well, they can say, you know, how is everything going in the relationship? Are you feeling bored? Is there anything that you want from me that you're not getting? You know, it can be a sign for someone to kind of look, you know, seriously at their relationship and say, well, this person may be a little bored, and so what can I do to add more spice and passion to my relationship so they have less of a need to live their fantasies elsewhere?
Well, hey, let me ask you, so just moving from that quickly, I don't know if you saw Miss America last night. I can't believe people still watch Miss America, but it's a big deal, right? And apparently. And they asked the new Miss America, Miss Georgia, about Deflategate and Tom Brady and whether or not the balls were inflated, whether or not he cheated. Is that just right in line with the fact that America's obsessed with football and it's in everything we do?
I mean, they wanted to find out, you know, her take on this scandal. I think that was a good question, and she handled herself well. You know, she gave an answer to satisfy, you know, the people that believe in Deflategate and the people that are also, you know, wary of it.
Where do you stand, Liz? Because it's become my new litmus test now. I'm a big Tom Brady fan. Where do you stand?
I mean, I don't really know. It's possible, but there's no hard evidence to show that he did cheat. It's just a matter of, I guess, whether we want to keep this story going and what purpose it's
so serving. Liz, according to your expert analysis, though, maybe Tom Brady is just not so happy with Giselle and he's taking it out on this little fantasy, this little cheating on whether or not the balls are inflated or not. Maybe that's it.
I mean, it's possible he could be a little bored in his relationship and he has to create some scandal in his professional life.
Liz Mandel, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Always happy to hear your take on things. We'll certainly be talking soon.